منذ البدء كانت الزراعة تتم في الأرض في التربة الخصبة، وكان المحصول الزراعي يعتمد بالدرجة الأولى على عوامل المناخ والمواسم خلال السنة. أما اليوم وبعد التطور الكبير للعلوم والتكنولوجيا والأساليب الزراعية، أصبح القطاع الزراعي لا يعتمد فقط على التربة والشمس والمناخ، بل هناك أساليب تقنية وعلمية وهندسية جديدة تحكم العملية الزراعية والمحصول الزراعي لتساهم في مواجهة أزمة الغذاء العالمية والتلوث البيئي والتصحر. من هنا ولدت تقنية المزارع العامودية الداخلية التي تعتمد على المياه، أو بالأحرى رذاذ المياه والإضاءة فقط. نزور اليوم إحدى أكبر هذه الأنواع من المزارع، أيرو فارمز، التي تعمل منذ العام 2004 وتبني اليوم مزرعتها التاسعة لزراعة الخضار الورقية، التي ستكون أكبر مزرعة عامودية في العالم، مقرها مدينة نيويورك بولاية نيو جيرسي في أمريكا.
قبل الدخول الفعلي لأيرو فارمز لازم نتجهز وكأنه داخلين على غرفة عمليات، لأن المزرعة هنا كغرفة عمليات بالدقة التي يتم متابعة المحصول الزراعي والشطور الموجود فيها، بحيث من أنه أي شيء بتعكر الجو وتعكر النظافة الموجودة داخل هذه المزرعة. نحن الآن داخل المزرعة العمودية، كما تشاهدون لا تراب ولا شمس، مزرعة تعتمد فقط على هذه الأبراج من حولي المثقلة بالتقنيات، تقنيات لمراقبة دقيقة للمحصول الزراعي. المحصول الزراعي الذي يحصل عليه من بعد أشهر في المزارع التقليدية يمكن الحصول عليه هنا من بعد أسابيع في هذه المزرعة الغير تقليدية، نموذج لمزارع المستقبل. هنا المحصول الزراعي خالي تماماً من الكيماويات وهو عضوي 100%. Mark, we are here at the seeding stage. Is this the first step or you have other ones before that?
Well, we actually have over 130 different standard operating procedures to run a farm. But it does start, a key part is with the seeding and the germination, and starts with actually our growing medium. We grow on cloth, mm-hmm. This is a reusable medium.
And she's tagging these cloths, right?
She's actually tagging, so everything's actually being monitored. So we're taking traceability to a whole new level. Mm-hmm. Here we're able to see right down to the square inch what's mm-hmm. happening. Out in the field, you can never have that level of control, that level of precision. So we think about from seed to package, how we set a new standard here in control indoor growing.
Tell me about the cloth.
So the cloth, this is something that's really unique to Aero Farms. We have patents around this. This is made out of 100% recycled plastic. Mm-hmm. So we're actually taking
plastics.
We're actually taking 24 water bottles out of the waste stream and converting that into something green and productive. So each one of these cloths represents about 300 water bottles. Mm-hmm. And it's BPA free. And again, we've done a lot of testing. Why it's so great is that it's reusable. So after we grow and harvest, and then we actually just clean it, and we actually are able to reuse it. So we've been using some of the same cloths for years. So we think about constantly every one of the inputs in our business. Mm-hmm. They go from here and they literally go into a black box, you know.
This black box. There's a mystery inside.
And this is the mystery. This is one of our germination chambers. But where we're able to provide the cues, the trick that seed and to start to growing. So out in the field, it may take 5 to 7 days, you know, when you plant that seed to start growing. We're talking about hours. So 24 to 48 hours, we're already starting to see that initial cotyledon and the radicle growing. And this is about how we can have a much faster growing process. We're creating the perfect environment for the plants so that they can really thrive. We typically are a little bit opaque because, again, it's this understanding of biology, engineering, environment, and our over 10 years of growing expertise that really makes it very special. And so we start the process. We actually have seeded. We're watering the plants now. So we're creating the perfect environment where the plants can thrive. Mm-hmm. And we're able to think about exactly what's needed, so that they can do well.
So you water them from the top. And
this is the only time. And then everything else, once we have it in our growing towers, mm-hmm. The misting, the aeroponics is going to take place underneath the cloth. This is an exciting part. We're showing literally hours, after that seeding part. We're already starting to see the initial growing part. So we see that initial cotyledon coming up, the radical has gone through the cloth, mm-hmm. and we're starting to see the beautiful growing process where, again, just in a matter of hours versus days, we're able to accelerate. So we talk about growing indoors and using controls and sensors. So they're set up everywhere. So we're constantly monitoring the plants. So we can see real time what's happening in each one of our growing towers. We can see the different elements. And we can see the history, we can see the different variables and how we manage that. Mm-hmm. And what we're trying to do here is actually understand, again, how to create the perfect environment for the plants and how to do it consistently. And so at real time, our team members can actually see it on their handheld computer as well, their phone, what's happening. So this is exciting because it means all of a sudden we can do the growing not only here in Newark, but we can see what's happening in Dubai, we can see what's happening in Tokyo. And so this has direct applications all over the world. Thank you.